Hi guys, how are you? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for those who are watching my videos. I really appreciate it and I cannot thank you enough. Guys, my channel is Auntie Konso and welcome to her channel. And if you are new to my channel, please click the red button and subscribe. So if I upload any video, you will never miss it. In today's video, I need to talk about did your office where you came with it from your country tells you the truth, or did they lie to you? Okay, first of all, I will say they lied everything about me, starting from the salary, work, everything. I cannot say that they told me the truth. No, I cannot say that, because when my aunt took me to that office, the owner of the office promised me I will get a good salary, and in that salary I will get off. And work would be much, but unfortunately things on the ground were totally different. It were totally different. Okay, when I reached, the thing I can say, I went to the house of a pastor, and I told the pastor I was a Catholic or ACK or other church. But when I reached here, guys, the church was none done. They call it Orthodox. In my life, I have never heard that church before. I even asked one of my friends if that church was in my country, and she told me yes, it is there, but in the main city, which is Nairobi, and most people who goes in that church, I think, are Ethiopians. I was surprised myself, because I thought I will be close, I will know much about about God, but none. And when they took me to the, okay, the house was not that big, the children were married. She had three children, a boy, two boys and a girl, but both were married, they have kids. So in this house we were three, a mother and her husband and me, which was okay, but I thought that maybe old people, like in my country, they're totally different. And when with these old people were very different. I was just bored. I feel unhappy because when you stay with, when you stay with an old person, you have to do everything by yourself. But this woman also wanted to do things by herself. So I was wondering, what kind of life is this? I do, he does. Okay, if you wanted to do something, why did you bring me here? You should leave me where I was and you continue by doing things alone. But in my when I looked the first time, the woman, she was already sick, and I told my friend, this woman is sick, and if he stays too long, maybe it will be 1 year. But I don't know why I told her that, but I see exactly what was wrong with her. So when we stay with her, that situation like that, sickness. Anyway, I will tell people who are staying with old people, before you come out from your country, ask questions about these old people. How are they? Are they sick? And which kind of disease are they seeking? Because for me, I didn't know anything else. They told me I'm going to stay with an old person, and but the husband is a pastor, which I knew that maybe a pastor can walk, can see. But when I reached, everything that I thought was very, very different. But thank God I stay with the woman 1 year, and God took her. May her soul rest in eternal peace. And also, so we were me and a husband, and when the woman died, the husband also started being in a health condition. I don't know, it was like a shock. So the woman died. So this girl man started, when he goes to urinates, he will urinate blood. So things started like this. I thought the only thing they say, drink water, drink water. For how long? This person, you see, you could take the person to the hospital the way he is, but they say that because his wife died, that is why. So things started like this. I will continue with the story to tell you how it went until I'll tell you more. So thank you so much. God bless you, and see you on my next video. Stay safe, and I love you.